on my knee. College begin, hop off a chick, belly get wrist. Cash through the morons, I get a check. You still a run on my pants and my cheeks. She not a dress, need up a mess. I eat a flesh, you know the rest. Count up a hundred, couple Rolex. Shine like the sun, you truly blessed. Who's on me take? When they clip up like a Uber D-Jets. This is on me, got my Gucci shirt wet. Him in my bag, don't get used to the rest. With this school, where they teach you finesse. I have missions for the drip, I invest. I'm the boss, man, I keep catching the dance. All the cool fast when they in with an S.
Now that I'm home, back out the road. We shut it down, where they sold. The checks on the streets, they number four. Send on my feet, put it on top.
Can somebody pinch me?
Timber, I got the info.
I feel like I'm frozen. I'm coming home. I feel like I'm frozen. I live a wide open. I'm talking to you.
Why
was
the actual
weather
information and
an update
on
what
it was?
Well,
if I'm being
honest, you know, it's their board, it's exactly like. Hands on my knee, always begins. Hop off the chick, belly get wrist. Cash through the moon, I get a check. You still a run on my pants and my chest. She not a dress, clean up a mess. I eat a flesh, you know the rest. Count up a hundred, couple Rolex. Shine like the sun, you truly best.
Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Debe. I make lifestyle content, and if that's your vibe, please do like, comment and subscribe. And if you're returning, welcome back, sis. As you can see, we're in Dubai. I just touched down, excuse me, looking a hot mess, child. But I am dehydrated, I am dry, I am hot, I am tired, but I am so grateful. So happy. So this is gonna be a travel vlog. I'm here for about four days, leaving Friday. It's a Monday today, September 3rd, I want to believe, don't quote me on that. Is now 10:43 Dubai time. We're 2 hours ahead Central African time, so not too bad. I did try and rest on the plane, but that didn't really work, so I just got into the room. So let's go for a room tour.
Only been a few hours, but it felt like days. Only been days, but it felt like months. Gone for a year, only know life once. Life moves fast when you do what you want. At this time, doing what I want. Hope you know what you want.
My new bitch look like Tyler Perry, but she don't love me, she too scary. My old bitch fun like Jackie Brown.
Hey,
I wanna know but she too down.
Absolutely love it, you guys. Absolutely love it. It is so hot. It is so hot. It's like, oh my gosh. Let me just connect to the internet. But it's giving 35 degrees at like 11 a.m., which is insane. Which is absolutely insane. All right, let me just get my bags. Hello? Yes, love it. Thank you so much for that. Yeah, much better. Say again. Oh, yeah, much appreciated. All right, thank you. Okay, we'll do that. Oh, I know, that's right. But otherwise, not too bad of a trip. Left Eswatini yesterday, that's Sunday, at 2:30. And okay, the only thing about this trip was that the border leaving Eswatini was insane. Like, there was the rally, I think it was. My brother was telling me about it, but literally the night before, I couldn't change any bookings because then the border was insane. So that kind of like set us back a little bit. But otherwise, it's usually because I take the shuttle, so it's usually 4 hours from Eswatini to the airport. But of course, like about 2 hours was added just because of the border only sort of thing. So when I got to OR, I had booked at a lounge and I was supposed to like spend time there editing, but I could only spend an hour, which is better than nothing. Ooh, let me tell about that lounge. Like, so crazy to me how it's literally like, it was like $400 to book it, like $428 if I'm exact. Why did I think that thing was for rich people only? Like, why did I think it was like thousands of rand? Like, I thought maybe it would cost like 2,000 to get in sort of thing. So I was kind of like shooting my shot a little bit. But, you know, in doing that, I just found it so funny how we kind of like, it's a mindset thing, you know what I mean? Like having an abundance mindset where you kind of like shoot your shot at things and you just find out that it's actually not that prohibitive as you would have thought it would have been. But it was just your mindset kind of already classing yourself out of certain situations and certain experiences, because I would always just like look at them white people, like them business people, like going into the Bidvest lounge, like, okay, nice for them, like, but I could never afford that, or I could never do something like that. But this time around, I was just like, let me just search, let me just find out, right? Like, let me just F around and find out how much this thing is. And it was $428. I was like, ciao. That time, the food is free, you get plug points, it's comfortable seating, you get Wi-Fi, like, full bar drinks, like shower, and then like the toilet is like, y'all saw that, like it's like the toilet and like the sink, it's like your own little bathroom when you're using the toilet. I'm sorry, I was like, worth it. Like, I just feel bad that I couldn't like spend. So I was supposed to leave at Eswatini at 2:30, get to Joburg at 6, check in, and then fly out at 10:30. So I was supposed to have like a good 4 hours just chilling. That's why I booked the lounge, because I was like, I'm not spending 4 hours sitting on a steel bench, child. Like, that's what I'm not finna do. So yeah, and then I only ended up just getting to Eswatini at 8 and then basically checking in and everything and getting to like sit down at 9. So I pretty much only had an hour, because then I had to rush for boarding, and luckily enough I got there like just in time when they were like boarding my zone. So that was the trip. I want to say something else though, in terms of like booking flights, and like, you know how I was flying Emirates, by the way, obviously, but there when you're booking, it's like it asks you to pay if you want like a preferential seat. So of course I'm trying to go for the content, and I'm like, I need to be guaranteed a window seat, and I paid for that. Was I not scammed because I got a middle seat? I'm like, I'm sorry, how is this middle? I could have sworn I booked window. Disappointing. And I just feel like going forward, don't even bother doing that, guys. Just like, if you want a window seat, just be first. Like, it's first come, first serve with these airlines, is what I've seen anyways. I could be wrong. I don't know, let's start a discourse. Do comment down below if I'm wrong. But I was like, okay, I got scammed there. And then again here with like this room, like I see some, because he's like, oh, there's these options. So he tries to sell me the other room. I was like, oh, okay, I trust your judgment. And I look at it and I'm like looking, and it's cute, like sea view, yes, but right in front of me is construction. I'm like, I don't see the vision. And he's just like, no, I thought it, like, it's better, like, well, how is it not better? And I'm like, I don't see the vision, I just don't. So can we do something? And he's like, all right, let me see. So that was him calling right now. And he's like, is that better for you? And I'm like, yes, I love it, thank you. And he's like, happy I was able to find a solution for you. I'm like, I know that's right. But a lesson I learned about that is just ask for what you want. Just ask for what you want. If it's not what you want, then say so. Like, why is it that as black women, we want to like always accept what we're given just because we're so like, we feel like we should be grateful type of thing. But if it's not what you want, or if actually it isn't the best, then you have license to say something, like you have a right to say something. So I kind of gave that a try and it worked. It worked. So yeah, that's just random philosophical talks just to settle in. I'm actually just waiting for all my stuff to get here. That's what I'm waiting for. That's why I'm like on my soapbox right now. So y'all will deal with me. But yeah, today, agenda for today is basically, I'm so glad I was able to check in early, so I just want to get settled. I don't know if I have time for a nap, but the only thing I had planned for today was trying out a beach club. So that's just going to be the vibe for my itinerary. Like, it's not going to be too busy. I do kind of like want to rest and relax above all else. So what I did with the itinerary is I booked just one thing per day, and then the rest of the time I'll just kind of figure it out, because I just want that open space. I don't want it to be like I'm rushing from one activity to the next, feeling stressed, or I don't want it to be like I'm always like running. Like, you know that TikTok talk about like people on vacation always wanting to do things, calm down type of thing, like type of vibe. I'll try find it, but like, yeah, I'm definitely the lay back, do nothing type on vacation. So that's exactly what I'm gonna do. So yeah, let's just wait on my stuff to get here, and then I think I'll pick you guys up when I'm about to head out, actually. Otherwise, I'm not really doing anything. Yeah. Hey guys, so my luggage came and I unpacked. Who is she? Almost done. Almost done, but I unpacked all my shoes and then all of my tops and stuff into the drawer. This is my underwear. So I'm super proud of myself. I'm super proud of myself. I just have some stuff that still needs to go on all the hangers. I just have it laid out on my bed. So all my stuff was from Shein, and that's the thing. I figured, let me hit two birds with one stone, such that as I'm unpacking all of my clothes, I'm also filming my Shein haul, so I can give you guys all the tea on all the stuff that I got and everything. So I'm actually kind of like working on that content at the same time, but the time is like 1 o'clock. My reservation at the beach bar is at 3, so I don't know if I should just like push on to like shoot this video, or just like, you know, take my time and relax for today and just shoot it tomorrow. I'm really not sure. I do know that I did some stuff already, like b-roll and stuff like that. So yeah, I guess we'll see, guys. Let me pick up with you guys when I actually leave. Hey you guys, so it's some time later and I'm ready to head out. I was just kind of like clearing up my room, hanging all these clothes up, and then I got ready for the past hour. So we have a reservation at Aura Skypool, but I'm just trying to figure out how to get there. I was trying to download what they call Kareem. It's like the Uber in the UAE, but like I'm struggling to find like my phone number. What was nice though is that they gave us SIM cards at the airport, like when you clear immigration, like you get a SIM card, and I activated it, and there's data, but I can't seem to see what my number is, and to register for Kareem, you need your number, so iffy, but I think I'm just going to head downstairs and see what they can recommend, and then I'll just try fix it later for tomorrow's sake. I just hope whatever solution they come up with is not too expensive. So just quickly, in terms of what I'm wearing, let me put y'all down. Y'all will see the Shein haul. So this is definitely it. And like my bag and the details, I got the Bottega dupe as well as the Van Cleef dupe. I got these from, this is from Shein as well, and then the Van Cleef dupe is from, there's some store at Hudson Emporiums for the Eswatini girlies that know, it's called Editorial Accessories. So I'll try link it down below. Absolutely love it. But I think let's head out, you guys, and figure out what we're finna do. What we're finna do. Ooh, let me take my earphones. Okay, you guys, so the guy downstairs said there's meter taxis actually around here. I'm so sorry, I actually didn't mention where I was staying. So I am booked at the Radisson Blue in Palm, Jumeirah. And it seems like all around this place, it's just like, you know, beach clubs and like resorts and stuff like that. So I think the place that I'm going to is actually about like 5 to 8 minutes away. So it's around this area. I could technically walk. But in this heat, guys, it's 37 degrees in Dubai right now. And yeah, no, the heat is killer. So if I were to walk, I think the promenade would be like, you know, 15 to 20 minutes. But I'm really not trying to walk in this weather. So I think we'll do a meter taxi. I just ran back up to my room because I wanted to change my bag. Like, content will kill you, bro. Like, before I had like this crochet bag, but I just had too many things that I was trying to bring with me. So I just brought my normal black bag. I think it's fine. I think it actually goes with the outfit just fine. So yeah, I'm about to head down and ask him to call me this taxi.
It's that bird in a VIP line with the V-Time and the Isaran. She drive a Nissan and she in a Beamer. I don't want her, cause she from the corner. And I heard that Beamer was an owner. My old man the owner. And I don't even drink Coronas. What type of drink you want, bro? I'm champagne for them. I'm dirty right for them. You come sip with me. If you like change the weather. If you want a little better. We can buy a grill whatever. Don't get too thirsty. I wanna tell the world about you just so they can be jealous. And if you see her for I do, tell her I wish that I never.
Turn on the lights.
I'm looking for her too. I heard she keep her promises, ain't never turned on you. I heard she ain't gon' cheat and she gon' never make no move. I heard she be down every time you need her, she call me. Turn on the lights. I'm looking for her. I'm looking for her.
Been living in London, like born and bred, something?
Yes.
No,
no, no, that. I didn't know she's an airplane controller in the 60s. And my youngest sister is 5.
Yeah, so that 8th grade is what's gonna get you. Yeah. So 10, I'm getting like, my oldest brother.
Little.
I'm in the middle. I'm 3 middle. Yeah, I'm number 6 in 8. Yeah. So I'm smack guy.
Oh, wow. I'm the oldest of 4.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And like the youngest is 13 now.
That's a big family.
Yeah, 6 is a big family. Hey guys, so it seems to be like a kind of promenade sort of thing. So I just left Aura Skypool, that was incredible. And the thing is, like, I showered there and I like was trying to, like, you know, rinse off my hair, rinse off the chlorine. So really, I'm just like kind of taking a nice stroll, really to dry my hair. That's the real reason, because I can't go back like into my room, into bed with wet hair. So I'm trying to, like, you know, try it out. And it's so gorgeous in here, guys. Please look, just look at the vibes, guys. Like, and this promenade is incredible. If I was like a runner person, I would definitely like be doing runs in the morning. It's just that I'm not much of a runner, but I think I might fake it this week. I think I might like put on a cute outfit and go for a run in the morning, please. Because look at this promenade, you guys. Absolutely gorgeous. Please just look at this views. And it's kind of dark. I'm so tempted to take pictures, but like I know it's kind of dark, so I don't know how that's gonna work. So yeah, let's just enjoy this. Not midnight, it's like 7 p.m. this night stroll, and then we'll just go back into the room and rest and like edit, because mind you, I flew in this morning and I didn't really sleep that well, so I'm actually exhausted, but it's just so pretty. It's just so pretty here. I'm loving it. So yeah, I'm just gonna enjoy this for the moment, and then I think I'll catch you guys tomorrow, because I mean, when I get to the room, I'm not gonna be doing anything, so. But we'll see. Do y'all see that? Oh my gosh. Y'all hear that sound, bro? Oh, Simsa says fire emojis. I know. I'm vlogging. So I'm like sitting by this beach club called Koko Bay, and the music is so amazing. I think I'm gonna go in and grab something to eat, because I do need to have dinner before I turn in. So I think let's do that. I'm not afraid to talking to you guys, but I'm just like enjoying this moment. And it's so beautiful at night, like it's super hot. I was with, so y'all saw that I made a friend. Y'all saw that I made a friend. So I'm like chilling, and this like UK baddie basically like comes up to me, and she's got like her tripod, whatever, and I've got the same. So I guess we kind of clicked over that, and then we were just taking pictures of each other, like with each other, and she was just like blown away. She was like, "You have an eye for this." So she's, shout out to Naomi, if I ever meet you again, you were absolutely incredible. I don't know why we didn't think of like exchanging at least Insta handles or whatever, but anyways, yeah, we clicked and we just hung out the rest of the time. So she's only in Dubai for like 3 days, so on Wednesday they move on to the States. So yeah, it's not enough time. I wish I could hang out with them again, but it was fun while it lasted. And yeah, no, aura exceeded expectations. I think the only thing was that the view wasn't that clear, so apparently that's because there's sandstorms in the summer. Ooh, do I not want to turn this TV down? So yeah, apparently that's because there's like sandstorms in the summer, so the view was a bit hazy. Like, aura was incredible. Food, 10 out of 10. Service, 10 out of 10. Vibes, like 11 out of 10. Like, it was so much fun and it was beautiful. So after that, y'all saw I went to like the promenade, and I was just like taking a walk, seeing what's out there. There's gang beach clubs, guys. I'm about to live my best life. Like, there's gang beach clubs. So I think we're about to just like do the promenade maybe on a daily basis in between things, see what vibes come up, sort of thing, because that was super fun. So yeah, tomorrow my excursion is at 8:30, which is pretty early, so I'm gonna go ahead and just wrap up for the night. So I'll see you guys tomorrow. Guys, so we are at, not sure what this place is called, I will ask, but it's a guided tour, Al-Sif, I think, and it's absolutely incredible, just very old town looking, and it's pretty much like a market, so we're just waiting on everybody to get here, and yeah, we're about to start our guided tour. It's so humid as well, I'm gonna have to like keep wiping the lens because wow, it's hot.
Also, during our tour, we talk about different topics like lifestyle, culture, history, religion. Please, whatever you have any question, feel free to ask. Even personal question, I will answer to be open. Read like that. Starting now. Now in Sharjah. Dubai, it's a new city. I'm gonna pass by, I show it for you. 1966, there is two leadership, they met each other and they decide to do a federation. Why? Because we want to take the independence from... No, not Saudi.
England?
Yeah, for sure. In the past, there's a British and there's a French. The British, they was ruling here in this area since 1258 till 1968. Why we want the independence? The direct reason is the British, they explore, discover the oil in the water side. Arabs, we love money. It's the reality. When you hear Al Maktoum, is the royal family of Dubai. Every state has own regulation, own police force, own system. Between the seven states, they are just sharing that.
Houses are made by the coral.
There is no like bricks or something. Coral means to build one house like that in the past, you need to spend 3 years. Why 3 years? Diving, getting some corals, not easy. We don't have machine and material. It's simple things. Also, all the house at the top, they have a towers. At least two tower. We call them wind tower. Our dialogues ruling by Dubai Ministry of Culture, the white flag. It's like a museum for you. Today, at least we're gonna visit two or three houses. Come with me to the air condition. Have a seat. Before I start explaining to you, it's Arabic word, means connection between many sides. You know, the Middle East generally, it's a good spot to connect the Asian, the African continent. Geographic, we are Asian. Before you leave the room, come with me, I will give you a briefing about the house. On one side, to the left or to the right, not this side. Majlis room. The summer room, we spoke about before, down to the wind tower.
At is like in a house, a kind of like, you know, staged house in terms of teaching us the Muslim culture and like showing us how they used to live, and basically like you just saw the courtyard and the guest room, and now this is, I'm in the kitchen right now. Ooh, thank goodness this house is air conditioned, you guys, it's so hot.
Just explain to you, give you a briefing about.
Okay, this is a wonderful example, freedom in belief. We have the Grand Mosque here. And next to you, the Hindu temple, Shiva. 7 years old. Since the beginning, we respect each other. We don't have any issue, any problem. Now we are next to the first market, textile market. If you want to purchase something, Kashmir, Pashmina, Lama Pashmina, between 20 dirham till 100, when they say 500 or 1000 dirham, it's okay. On your place, I will start my price with 20 dirham. Let him be upset. That he will know,
he'll
you know
the price.
Okay? And the souq is like that. You go through the market, you have the good deal or the bad deal. Don't be surprised. And one thing else, whatever you pay for this stuff, on your home back, it's much expensive. Mm. Why? On your home, you are paying tax on it, okay? Keychain, fridge magnet, per piece, 5 dirham. If you are expert how to haggle, 3 pieces, 10 dirham. Maybe you like ceramic plate, the curling one, Turkish one.
Your homeboy is putting us on game, chat, because we finna go shopping and he don't want us ripped off or be acting a fool. About to get some snacks quickly, little snack pack before we start our shopping.
Okay, thank this you, is sir. A falafel sandwich, samosas, everything is built chari.
Thank you.
Yeah. Let's take a seat for a minute.
So this is like a little veggie samosa thingy Mokobi they gave us. So there's a whole lot of like samosa, like, we'll have to taste the rest later, but for now this is fuel. Cool. checking out all the markets, and we started with the textile market, and now we are in the spice market and headed into the gold market. Very comprehensive tour, I will not lie. Absolute value for money, great tour guide. Love it, love it.
Yeah, that's real, all real.
Oh.
And one thing, there is no police force. You're gonna work, no security, nothing. In your country, no.
Yeah, I could never.
At night time when they close,
yeah,
they just close the door. The I'm items
can be there's not even any butler doors.
No. Safety is 100%.
Yeah. Because it's not even, like, in my country. Amazing.
Guys, so here good. We're done with our tour. I wish all of you enjoyed this tour. Thank you so much for being patient with me in this heat. If you want to start your shopping, this is the book.
All right, you guys, end of tour. So now I'm just about to go get a taxi. So it was a pickup, yes, but like the drop-off, it's like people would still want to do some shopping, so they don't include the drop-off for that reason. But I'm kind of done. I'm shopped out, so I want to just like get home and relax, get a break, maybe grab some lunch. So yeah, I think I'll catch up with you guys later. Matcha latte with almond milk, please. One pump of vanilla if you can.
You can't afford it. I'm on my dogs and we out in shortage. You got a shortage on your funds and I got a long clip on my guns. Sounds like fun. I got no shortage. I'm no bum. Reach for my pearls and you're done. Reach for the purses. Wearing designer, I'm in the future. I got a future, I'm in a new truck. I'm in a booth, yeah, drinking kombucha. Singing with Smiley, speaking me highly. Tryna go Kylie, I wake up finally. Suffering silence, waking up violent. Checking the finest.
Oh, hey you guys. So I am finally back in the room. Y'all, Sephora, dream come true. And like this lady was just like kind of like touching me up, because like all my makeup like melted. I actually think I need to redo everything right now, but if you can see like a bit like on my mustache, but you can't see that much. Why? Because she touched me up. And y'all, the Fenty Beauty Pro Filter, I'm like already regretting leaving it. Like, I didn't buy it. Okay, so haul. I think the biggest thing, I should have actually like spent less at the market. Like, had I thought, I actually wouldn't have bought like dumb stuff in the market. I definitely would have just like saved all my money for Sephora, because then I wanted everything under the sun there. But I think no harm, no foul, no love lost. Let's get into, I'm just trying to empty everything out of my bag so that I don't forget to show you guys anything. So just fridge magnets, no biggie, just touristy stuff. And then of course I got some abayas is what they're called, so you know, like the regalia type of vibe. I got one for myself and then I got one for my mom. I think it comes with a scarf as well. And then what really, and then I got like some dumb stuff. So I got like a t-shirt. I need not have gotten this at all, but like I just felt like meh, why not? So I got that. If anything, maybe I should have gotten a large. I don't know why I got a medium, but the quality is pretty decent. And then I got a scarf. Maybe I shouldn't have got one because I feel like they'll give us tomorrow on safari. I'm praying that they do. So maybe I didn't need to buy this, but I got this for my brother. He had said he wanted one some while ago. I'm just also hoping that maybe it was a phase and it hasn't passed yet. But what I really spent time doing, and y'all saw me like at the tech, at the market, perfumes, chat. I got all the perfume in the world, perfumes. So that's what I got at the market. And then at Sephora, it's right there. Ooh, Sephora haul. I got the Fenty Beauty butter drop. Absolutely like a dream, a literal dream come true for mine. I once got a Fenty kit. My cousin, she lives in LA, and she came in to visit, and she got me a travel sized Fenty like starter pack sort of thing. So I tried out Fenty Skin. It was the cleanser, toner, moisturizer plus FPF. So hear it from me, Fenty Skin is not worth it, except for this, except for the butter drop. The butter drop is incredible. Like I know as African girlies, we know how to globisa, like we know how to moisturize, you know what I'm saying? But this, another level. So I had to get it. And then I got the Fenty Beauty, hope you guys can see it. It is the Liquid Kilowatt Fluid Freestyle Highlighter in Honey Haughty. And this stuff, like this is the stuff I have. I don't know if you can see it, but this stuff, when she put it on me, I said, kilowatt. It says kilowatt, and really it's killer. And on my face, she touched me up with the Pro Filter Foundation, and then in 350, and then she put like a little bit of like cream blush. Oh, please. I'm like looking at myself in like the reflector thingy. So cute. You guys, I think I'm gonna have to go back to Dubai Mall and get that Pro Filter. And like, it's annoying me because I just bought a powder. I just got like Black Opal just the other day. But this is the life, guys. Ooh! And then I got Brazilian, what's it called? Oh, I got the Brazilian Crush, but this is Sol de Janeiro. Like, it's like a perfume spray sort of thing. So yeah, I just got this for the vibes, and vibes it is. I'm busy getting this for the vibes, and I'm not getting like Pro Filter. Where are my priorities? Like, but it's like when I saw it, I was like, I gotta try it. I absolutely gotta try it. So yeah, I think I'm gonna try and go back to Dubai Mall, I think on Thursday. So I didn't wanna kind of max myself out with shopping today. I think I'm done with shopping, you know what I mean? But the reason I didn't get those two products that I really wanted from Fenty Beauties because I didn't want to like max out. Like I think on Thursday, if there's change and everything, I'll go back and, you know, finish the monies. So I'm just going to chill out for a bit. Chill in the room. And yeah, see what I, because it's 3 p.m. now. So I think I'm going to have like a sunset dinner or like even like take a lap around, like walk around a little bit. Or actually, I think while my makeup is looking as good as it is now, I might just film that Shein haul and then we'll go out for dinner. So I think that's what I'm going to do now. Did I tell you guys I got lost? I 100% got lost in the market. Like, so I'm buying these perfumes. And you know what? I think that's my mistake. Like, choosing perfume. But like, my thing for Dubai was that I wanted an abaya. I wanted a scarf. And I wanted, like, I knew, like, the souvenir things that I wanted to get. And I got exactly that. And I wanted perfumes, right? So I just wanted to get it out of the way. Amazing perfume and, like, perfume oils. So those smelled amazing. But the thing about perfume is that it's subjective. You kind of have to think on it. And he literally gave us, like, 20 minutes. The thing is with that tour, like I said, they pick you up when you go there. But they don't drop you off because that's when they then give you time to like shop and do whatever you want, right? Now that they've showed you everything. So we went to the textile market, the spice market, and the gold market. So once you see them all, then he's like, I do y'all. I'ma hang with y'all if you want, if you need my assistance sort of thing. But I was like, nah, I'm done. I gotta go. But between the textile market, so in the textile market is where I got the perfumes. And a subject like 20 minutes is not enough, guys. Like, I'm literally, and I'm like to the guy, yo, I gotta go. Like, can I pay and go? He's like, no, smell this. And of course I smell it. And of course it's amazing. And of course I want to add it. So I got like a couple perfumes, but I wanted something for myself and my mom and my dad. There's a lot of people I was buying for. So I kind of took long doing that. And then next thing I know, it's like the time to like be at the meetup place. And like when I run there, I'm like, they're like asking me like, are you okay? What are you looking for? And I'm like, oh, I'm looking for the tour guide people. And they're like, he went that way. So I run the opposite direction and I run, I don't see him. And I change my mind. I'm like, no, let me go back to the pickup point sort of thing. But like, so stressful. Then I was like, you know what, let me actually go back into, and actually, wow, at like the store where I got this, I took it, and then because I was rushing when I was in that store, because I was rushing to meet back with the group, I ended up not paying for it. So that guy is now running after me the whole time I'm running around the market, and he's like, wah, da, da, da. And then like he's talking and I'm like, why is he hounding me? And then he's like, you didn't pay, you didn't. And I'm like, oh, my bad. So while I'm paying for that, I'm like, can I use your phone? So I take the phone and I call the tour guide. And he's like, nowhere in the spice market now. And I'm like, where the hell is that? And they're like, yeah, you go where? And then get on the boat and then cross like the river sort of thingy-mo-bobby. And that's where the spice market is. And we're at the entrance. They will wait for you type of thing. So that's how I ended up sorting myself out. Otherwise, that was a lot. That was a lot. But it was fun though. And it's so funny because I feel like even just like how I am with like how I'm dressed and everything, everyone's like probably thinking, oh, that's the fashion girly. Of course she's gonna overshop. You know what I mean? Like I was just like, I know you guys are judging me. But it was super fun. So yeah, anyways, let me actually just knock this video out and just get it out of the way before the light changes, because the light is pretty good. So yeah, later. Hey guys, it's a little bit of time later. I'm done shooting my Shein content, so I'm about to go and relax at the beach. Here's one of the looks that I was shooting. Let me just show you guys, maybe in the mirror. I don't know if it shows. Just kind of wearing like this crochet dress with this trusty tote. Yo guys, Aura Skypool came in clutch with the tote and the fan, because I had forgotten to buy a fan on Shein. I forgot it in like the cart, as well as I forgot to bring like my tote bag, so I was screwed. And they hooked a sister up, because now I'm carrying it everywhere. It's still a bit sweltering outside. It's 5 p.m. and I'm hoping that, you know, the sun is going down a little bit. It could be like a bit easier to be outside. I packed my book, gonna pack some water, and maybe like I'll have a drink or two just to relax after that very exhausting recording session. And then, yeah. So plans is kind of pretty chill. Like I said, I'm out here to chill and relax. I'm not out here to do too much. So I'm gonna chill at the beach and then figure out something for dinner. And then, yeah, that's it for the rest of the day. So.
I'm just in a bus, sitting sideways, waiting, looking all the time. Time gets a ticking and it takes a toll. Told you I couldn't really draw the line. Line ringing, saying that you told me things, things that you really kept inside. Sidetracking me when I was good to you. You were somebody I would stand behind. I know you like a drink to the sun up, grind till you come up, work all winter, shine all summer, ride for your brother, die for your mother, keep that shit a hunter. I know you wanna vacate to a place where you could take pictures, post on Insta. Your friends say they miss you, but they don't really miss you. Sitting sideways, waiting, you looking all the time. Time in and left you with a broken heart. Hardly excuses how you play with mine. Mind in my business and you show up. Up to no good, I should have seen the signs. Signing me here to do your dirty work. Working to try and get you off my mind. I know you like to drink to the sun up. Grind till you come up. Work all winter. Shine all summer.
Okay, you guys, get unready with me. I just got back into the room. Y'all see how amazing that nighttime view is? Oh, guys, West Beach, like if you're ever visiting Dubai, I would 10 out of 10 recommend living in the West Beach area, the Palm West Beach area. Oh, absolutely amazing. And Koko Bay Beach Club, it's giving 2 out of 2 because I was there last night just by chance, and I run it back today. Like, and you also got I also got a beach bag and the little sandal thingies, which was so nice. So I'm just using this Garnier Moss micellar water. You guys saw this when I had like my self-care vlog, when I did my self-care vlog, and I just put it in a spray bottle because I like to kind of like spray it on my face and let it sit for a bit to like percolate. And like the makeup literally starts running off, because y'all know I'm usually a, oh, my battery's about to die, so maybe let me hurry this up. And yeah, no, I was just chilling by the water. So West Beach has like operating hours, and I got there at like 5, and they were, West Beach was like closing at like 6, so after 6 they don't allow anybody to like be swimming in the water and stuff. But I felt like 1 hour was enough. They did let me stay like on the sunbed. Oop, a lash clutched cluster just came up, but it had been bothering me all day, so I'm not sorry. I did put some makeup on my neck as well, so let me get that. So, and I just sat by the beach. I'm running out of cotton pads. Sat by the beach reading SJP's book, and y'all, God did something with that woman, because that book is amazing. 10 out of 10 recommend. So now in with my cleanser that I decanted into these little bottles, because I'd be damned buying a travel size. Is my skin still broken out? I think it is. So my skin broke out literally yesterday. First of all, I'm mad because I'm on my period. Like, why am I on my period on vacation? So I'm like hella bloated, and like my skin does its own thing. That's one. But two, I ate a candy bar. Like, I ate a PS caramel. I don't even like PS. Like, I don't know like what business I had eating that, because literally minutes later, like all over the side of my face. It's getting a bit better now, so I'm grateful, and at least I'm aware of like what my triggers are. I said more money, more problems, bring on the problems, bring on the problems, bring on the mob. Going in with my hyaluronic acid from, like, is it Revolution or Skin Revolution? I can't be sure. On damn skin, they say. So that it locks the moisture in. I am so tired. So I don't even know if I'm gonna make it to dinner tonight. I think I might just like order in some room service. So this is my retinol. My doctor did describe me retinol to like work on my breakouts and stuff. Like, the skin journey is just, it's taxing, it's emotionally draining, but I think you really do learn to kind of accept yourself as you are and not tie like your value on your external appearance and stuff like that. So it's been a learning curve for me, because I had never had acne at all in my life. Like, I was glass skin girly number one. Like, I was the OG glass skin, like way before Korean and none of that. But I just think, okay, now I'm going in with my niacinamide and zinc, also from Skin Revolution. Oh. And then I really just don't know what happened. I think it was hormones. I remember once I started having acne, I think like in my early 20s, but it turned out to be the milk I was drinking. So that's when I went, like, in fact, I had gone dairy free already because I noticed milk was breaking me out. But then I tried like a no lactose milk, but I think who knows what else they put in that stuff, you know what I mean? So now I just do organic nut milks or oat milk type of thing. Looking for my moisturizer now. Where did I put it? Where is it? Motherfucker, where is it? Just trying to remember if I forgot anything. I don't think so. Almost forgetting. Where's my eye cream? Where's my eye cream? And I don't know why I'm actually doing my skincare before the shower. Oops. I would definitely do my skincare after the shower, but I totally forgot. I just wanted to get like all the gunk off of my face, guys, because yeah, today was a heavy makeup day. I put on makeup and then I went to Sephora and the lady was just playing around on my face. So I just wanted to get that stuff off ASAP. That's for sure. Oh, so now I am, why is this thing tinkering the way that it is? moisturizer, and I forgot my Laneige sleep mask. So I'll just put my Carmex on and go to bed. Yeah, guys, nothing else left for the night. I'm literally just gonna chill and cop an early night. I'm actually not gonna do dinner because I can't see myself putting a face on once again. So I think I'll just see you tomorrow. Later, currently 12:15, and I'm just running out to the mall real quick. I realized yesterday that there actually might be a mall on West Beach, Nakheel Mall, sometime. So I'm just gonna go outside and ask, and then I wanted to grab a few things. I need to find an adapter for my plug. So I'm in Dubai, and they don't use, like, they use like square pin plugs, and mine is like a round pin, and there's not a single adapter or converter. So I want to take this with me because I want to try see if I can find that. And the thing is, I wanted to like start some editing. Like sometimes I have downtime, whereas I kind of want to start organizing this vlog and like edit and stuff like that. But if not, it's fine. I could always just like relax and read, you know what I mean? So yogurt as dessert. The time now is like 1:10, which is perfect. I'm going to eat this and then head back to the hotel and change for to be ready for the next excursion, which is happening. I think pickup is between 2:45 and 3, so I have ample time. Y'all, it is 2:30 and my car's downstairs, so just headed down to catch that. And like I said earlier, next on the itinerary is the desert tour. So this is what I'm wearing real quick, but watch my Shein haul, everything is linked in there. And yeah, let's have fun. So we've just made a stop here. It's quite interesting. Of course the cars need to like cool off because of all they was doing. Like they was doing the most, guys, like literally like tilted on the side. That was hectic. And I'm like, in my car there's like a family, right? And it's two little boys and they're like, wee! The whole entire time. I found that so cute. It's like my inner child, but I can't exactly say, like, they're saying it for me. But anyways, yeah, just giving everybody an opportunity to take photos while the cars cool off, and then from here we'll be going to the camp. So we just did some camerides and now we're about to head into the camp for the performances and hopefully some snacks and stuff like that. It is about 6 p.m. It's showing up much lighter on camera, but it's actually getting quite dark. But yeah. Fair to let. Yay!
Was everything? Camel ride was good?
So I'm about to head out just for a little bit of like a quick drink, a nightcap, whatever, see what's good outside. So just for a quick outfit, I took the top off. I just did a little bit of a day to night transition, threw on a bikini because I'll be heading to one of the beach clubs. I kept my pants and the summer trench. And then I just kind of like ran a refresher towel, spritzed some perfume, and hit this Fenty Beauty Kilowatt. I don't know if you guys can see it, but I just added that to my face because my makeup did hold up. So proud of it. But yeah, that's the fit for the night. I'll catch up with you guys on my fourth day tomorrow. Mwah. So good morning, you guys. It is a new day, day 4, and my last day. Thank you.
Sorry.
Sorry.
First time.
First time. Yeah.
How long ago?
30 minutes.
And we're here in our last excursion. I'm doing jet skiing. I'm at a place called Jetski. And yeah, we're gonna try something new. It is quite hot and I don't know why I picked 11 a.m. But I just felt like maybe 2 p.m. might have been hotter, so I think we'll make do, and yeah, let's have fun. Just thought I'd check in. I'm on the move again. I just spent the past 2 hours or so just packing some of my dirty clothes, just like a little bit of packing, because I know I'm gonna be leaving tomorrow early, so I kind of wanted to get ahead of that. And then, you know guys, the real challenge that I have is that it's just way too hot. Oh, I'm so bright. It's just that it's way too hot here. So I literally was not able to do anything outside until now. It's like 10 to 4, so I think I'm gonna like go exploring the promenade in the other direction. I know I went down south the other day, but now I just wanna go further up and see what's good there. And yeah, I think it's like the sun's a little bit, you know, going down a little bit, so it's not hectic. Otherwise I could not deal with the heat. Not much that I'm wearing, just like this little workout set and some sneakers, and then I got my little beach bag. So